Good morning to Vandal. Let us have a look into the last section review. We have studied about LTI systems, linear time invariant systems. Let us represent input sequence as x of n, and h of n is the impulse response of LTI system. That should be LTI system, impulse response of the LTI system. Then the output sequence can be found with the help of impulse response as follows. V of n equals to x of n linear convolution with h of n. And the expression for that is, this is the expression for that. Sigma k equals to minus infinity to plus of k into h of n minus k. This part we have seen in the last class. Let us have a look into how to compute linear convolution. This is what we had discussed in the last class. What we had done is, if you are having the input x of n like this, sigma k goes minus infinity to infinity, x of k, delta of n minus k, then what we are going to do is, for each input samples, we will try to find the output separately. And due to linearity property, we will try to add all those outputs together in order to get my final output y of n. That's what we had done in the last class. For example, this is my input sequence x of n. This is the impulse response of that LTA system. Then what we are going to do is, first we'll try to construct this particular sample. Yeah, what is this sample? This sample is nothing but x of minus 2. This is x of minus 2 into delta of n plus 2. This sample corresponds to x of 0 into delta of n. X of n, x of 3 into delta of n minus 3, this one. I'll try to consider this non-zero sample first. X of minus 2 into delta of n plus 2. And if I found what is the response I'm going to get? If my input is x of minus 2, delta of n plus 2, then what is the response I'm going to get? The concerned output from this system. You can apply linearity property and time invariant property. If delta of n plus 2 is the input, then what is the output of this LTA system? When input is delta of n, output is h of n. That is the impulse response, right? Input is delta of n, output is h of n. When input is delta of n plus 2, then what is the output we are going to get? What is the output? Output we are going to get for this one is h of n plus 2. After that, multiplication by constant due to that linearity. In linearity, that homogeneity property there, right? A into x of n leads to a into y of n, like that. X of minus 2 into h of n plus 2. Similarly, when this is the input, the concerned output for this one is x of k. When this is the input, it's already output, right? Delta of n minus k. This is my input. When this is my input, then the concerned output I'm going to get is into h of n minus k. And I will try to add all of the outputs due to that linearity property, LTA system, right? That's what we had done here. For this input, this is the output. Output we are going to get is x of minus 2 into h of n plus 2. H of n means that will be from 0 to 2, right? N plus 2 means shifted left side by 2 units. 0 will be shifted to minus 2, 1 will be shifted to minus 1, 2 will be shifted to 0. Shifted left side by 2 units. And after that multiplication with x of minus 2. When this is the input, x of 0 into delta of n, the output we are going to get is x of 0 into h of n. And when this is the input, x of to delta of n minus 3, output I'm going to get is x of 3 into h of n minus 3. And finally, I want to know my output y of n for the given input. Add all these outputs, That's what I'm going to do. And then to add all the three outputs, finally I'm going to end up with this expression, end up with this graph. This is one interpretation of convolution. Let's have a look into another interpretation of convolution. This expression for convolution, y of n equal to sigma k goes to minus infinity of k into h of n minus k for all n, where n is integer. N can be any integer, negative or positive, or that can be zero. For a particular value, we'll try to find h of n minus k for all k, and then take the inner product with x of k. Yeah, we'll have a look into that example. Just consider some example. Let me consider this as my impulse response of the system. Three, four, and so on. Yeah, can someone tell me what will be my h of k, where k equal to zero, index? Yeah, I should speak out. Minus one, minus two, and so on. What will be my h of k? I'm just renaming n with k. Yeah, what will be my h of k? H of n is this one. Then what will be my h of k? See, h of k also once again some sequence, right? What will be my h of k? See, I'm just renaming this one. In place of n, I changing this name to k. That's what. Nothing more than that. Once again, I am going to get the same thing. For k equal to zero, this is two. For k equal to one, that is one, right? For k equal to two, that is three. This is what I am going to get. H of k, k versus h of k, n versus h of n. You can see, right? N equal to zero means h of zero. H of zero equal to two. N equal to two, n equal to two means two. Here h of two is three. Similarly, you can try this, right? For k equal to 0, h of 0, that is same as 2. For k equal to 1, h of 1, that is same as this one, right? For k equals to 2, h of 2, that is same as 3. And what will be my h of minus k? It's a folding operation. Yeah, you can speak out. I want to plot k versus h of minus k. This is my h of k. I want to fold this. Can someone answer? What will be that one after folding? Yeah, I can speak, right?
We have at minus 1 and minus 2.
Okay, you can have a look into this graph and answer. If you try to fold this, what I want to get? Folding means with respect to 0, right? This will be shifted to which location after folding? Yeah, you can speak.
Minus 2.
Yeah, it's fine. It will be shifted to minus 2. And this will be shifted to minus 1. And this will be same, right? Minus 0 is nothing but 0. This will be shifted to minus 2. This will be shifted to minus 1. This will be in the same location. It will be 2 and it will be 1. It will be 3. After folding, I'm just folding this one. After folding, I got this. Now, suppose if I ask you, what is h of 2 minus k? Then how to compute h of 2 minus k? Is it left shift or right shift? Just consider this one. Will you try to shift this right side or will you try to shift this left side?
Left shift.
No, this is right shift actually. Yeah, I'll tell the reason for that. K minus 2. Do you agree this? These two are equal, right? Minus k plus 2 is nothing but 2 minus k. First, I am folding this one, h of k. After that, for the shift right side by 2 units. I'll let you shift this right side by 2 units. H of 2 minus k means. I'll let you shift this h of minus k right side 2 units or 2 samples. Then I'm going to get like this will be shifted to 0, right? And this will be shifted to plus 2 means this will be 1. This will be shifted to 2. And all others are zeros. This will become like h of 2 minus k. If you have doubt, what you can do is just go to your actual one and equate 2 minus k to all pieces. 2 minus k equal to 0 implies k equal to 2. It means this will be shifted to 2, index 2, right? You can see that got shifted to index 2. This index 2, right? And 2 minus k equals to 1 implies k equals to 1. This will be in same location, right? You can have a look into this. That is in the same location. And once again, 2 minus k equals to 2 implies k equal to 0. This will be shifted to 0. Shifted to 0, right? See, if that is h of k minus 2 or if that is h of k plus 2, then h of k will be shifted left side by 2 units. H of k will be shifted left side by 2 units. If that is h of minus k plus 2, then h of minus k will be shifted right side by 2 units. Yeah, if you got some doubt, you can do something like that. This basic one. Once you get clarified, then you can do. Then what about h of minus 1 minus k? This can be written like h of minus half k plus 1. We are folding that. After folding, I am trying to do this left shift by one sample, right? Left shift by one sample. Once I got folded version, I let shift this left side by one sample. Left side by one sample means this will be shifted to minus 1. This will be shifted to minus 2. This will be shifted to minus 3. Left side by one sample shifting means. That thing you can observe. This is nothing but shifting left side, shifting that h of minus k left side by one sample. And if I say this one, h of 1 minus k, then shifting this right side by one sample. And if I say h of n minus k, yeah, what is the meaning of this one? Yeah, you should answer. For n greater than 0, what is the meaning of this? Yeah, what is that? Is shifting left side or right side?
right side by n units.
Okay, shifting h of minus k right side by n units. N samples. Suppose h of n minus k where n less than 0 implies shifting that folded version h of minus k left side by how much? Mod n samples, right? Mod n samples. For example, if I consider -3, it means shifting left side, shifting h of minus k left side by 3 samples. Yeah, this difference you can see. This is just an example. This is impulse response of my LTA system, h of k. H of n actually I will write, but I'm renaming n with I need some notation similar to this convolution sum. H of n minus k I have, right? For this I am doing all these things. First I will fold that. After that, shifting. See h of k. And see h of minus k, folded version. Folded version means this will be going to -6. This will go to -6. And this folding. This remains at the same location. And this corresponds to, yeah, you can have a look into this. H of n minus k. H of n minus k. For example, if n greater than 0, if n greater than 0, in this case, they consider n equal to 4. Okay, this is from discrete time signal processing by Oppenheim book. This reference figure. Here we consider n equal to 4. H of 4 minus k means shifting h of k right side by 4 samples. It means 0 will be shifted to 4. You can have a look into this. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. This sample shifted to 4, right? N equal to 4. And -6 will be shifted to how much?
-2.
N equal to 4 means -2, right? -6 plus 4. Shifting right side by 4 samples. See -2. N equal to 4. Let us have an example to illustrate this linear convolution operation. Consider a system with impulse response as follows. H of n equals to u of n minus u of n minus n. Okay, I'll ask a question. Yes. What is this? Equals to 1 for 0 for n equals to u of n minus u of n minus 4. Yeah, h of n equals to u of n minus u of n minus 4. Then h of n equals to 1 for which values of n? Yeah, someone is answering, right? Yeah, for which values of n?
0 at 1, 2, 3, we have answer, and else 0.
Okay, 1, 2, 3, till 3, right? For example, if I consider u of n, that equal to 1, for all n greater than equal to 0. And u of n minus 4 means, this got shifted to 4, right? Equals to 1, For all n greater than or equal to 4, this part 6 and so on equals 1. If I subtract these two things, this gets cancelled out. All this gets cancelled out. Only this part will be left over. Equals to 1 for n equal to 0, 1, 2, 3. Otherwise, 0. Right? That's what we are going to have. It means this is my h of n. Zero, one, two, and three. For example, if I replace this one with capital N, then what will be my h of n? Zero to n minus one, that will be one. Zero to n minus one, the h of n will be one. See, when there is a four, it becomes three, right? When there is n, this will become like n minus 1, the last one. And all others are zeros, except 0 to n minus 1, capital N minus 1. Okay, this is my h of n. And my x of n is the input of this LTI system with this impulse response. A power n for n greater than or equal to 0. That can be written as a power n u of n, right? A power n u of n. These two are equivalent representation. Let me try this example. Okay, let me consider A belongs to 0 to 1. This is in the open interval. Is it decreasing or increasing? A power n. In this case, if you have doubt, consider 0.1 for example. A equal to 0.1. A equal to 0.1, then what happens to A power n? Is it decreasing or increasing?
Decreasing.
Decreasing, right? This is a decreasing function. If I try to plot this one, then I am going to get. Just consider A belongs to 0 to 1. It's a decreasing function. For n equal to 0, for all others that is 0, right? Before n, into u of n is there. A power 0 means 1. And A power 1 means A, right? And A square means less than A. Because it's a decreasing function, I consider A equal to 1. Some case I consider. A cube is 3 and so on. This is A power 4. And so on. This is some sort of exponential nature decaying, right? As you can see, this is my x of n, n versus x of n. This is my input sequence. And the impulse response I am going to consider is u of n minus 4. This is my impulse response of my LTA system. Once I know the impulse response of the LTA system, I can find the output or the response by linear convolution, right? X of n convolution with h of n. This can be written like sigma k equals to minus infinity to plus infinity x of k h of n minus k. Problem belongs to z. Some of them might be zeros. Yeah, not to worry about this. Can I write like this? Is there any problem if I write like this? Are they equal or unequal? In place of minus infinity plus infinity, I am writing 0 to infinity. Is it true in this example? Is it true or false? It's true, right? A power n u of n. U of n equal to 1 for all n greater than or equal to 0. It means a power n into u of k. U of k equal to 0 for all k greater than or equal to 0. Otherwise, that is equals to 0, right? U of k equals to 1 in this interval only. 0 into something is 0, right? That's why I have written only this part. The a power k, right? Yeah, a power k into u of k. Okay, can someone answer? Yeah, this can be written as follows. Okay, the graphical view I want, right? H of k is nothing but k equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, equal to 1. And all others are zeros. This is my H of k. I want to know h of n minus k. I want to find h of n minus k first. After that, I'll try to multiply with x of k. That's what my plan. I want to do this operation. For that, I want to compute this h of n minus k. H of n minus k. First, I'll fold this one. After folding, yeah, from what point I'm going to get like 1? Yeah, I can speak out.
Minus 3 to 0.
Yeah, minus 3 to 0. Yeah, it's fine. The minus 1 after folding. And otherwise, this is equal to 0. This is my h of minus k. H of minus k. And I want to find h of n minus k. Before that, yeah, just for your understanding, I'll try to write this. This is my convolution sum. And this is my x of k. Decaying, right? Like this. For all others, that is 0. This is my x of k. 0 and something is 0. That you can keep in your mind. And I know. Suppose I want to find h of minus 1 minus k. Then what will be my h of minus 1 minus k? Will you shift this left side or right side? Will you shift this left side by one sample or right side by one sample?
Left.
Left side, right? Left side by one sample. H of minus 1 minus k means. It means I'm going to get this equals to 1 between minus 4 to minus 1. Minus 4 to minus 1. Shifting left side by one sample, right? Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, and all are 1s. Minus 4. This is my h of minus 1 minus k and 0 for all others. 3, 4 and so on. Similarly this side. All others are zeros except this part. Now I want to do this operation. It is something like dot product of x of k and h of n minus k. Point to point multiplication. After that I will try to add both. After multiplication, I'll try to add all those samples. Yeah, what is the point to point multiplication of this and this? What is x of k into h of minus 1 minus k?
0.
0 for all k. 0 for all k, right? 0 for all k. In the case where I consider n equal to minus 1, or n equal to minus 1, I replace n equal to minus 1, right? Because you can see, whenever HR minus 1 minus k is non-zero quantity, this is 0, right? You can see, at minus 1, this is non-zero, equal to 1, right? But at minus 1, this is 0. 0 into 1 is 0. Similarly, 0 into 1 is 0. And all others are 0 into 0s, this side. And if you consider this, whenever this is non-zero, this is 1, this is a, a square, a cube, and so on. 1 into 0 is 0. I want to multiply the same index. This is 0, right? Into a is 0. 0 into a square is 0. And 0 into a power 4 is 0. Okay, this also, right? 0 into a cube also 0. Everything else is 0. And sum of all those zeros is 0, right? We have summation finally. Sum of all those zeros is 0. That's what we are going to get, right? Then my y of minus 1 will be 0. N equal to minus 1. What I had done is y of minus 1 I computed at single point of n. Replace n with minus 1. Till now I had done this one. Y of n equals to minus 1 equal sigma k equals to minus infinity plus infinity x of k h of minus 1 minus k. That's what I had done. Can someone tell me what is y of n equal to minus 2? Is it 0 or non-zero?
0, sir.
Okay, is it 0? See, definitely this is also 0. See, the reason for this one is h of minus 2 minus k is nothing but shifting this whole sequence. Shifted to minus 2, shifted to minus 3, like that, right? Otherwise, you can think like shifting this sequence left side by one more unit. This will be minus 2, this will be minus 3 location, minus 4, minus 5 location. You are going far away from non-zero samples, right? You can do multiplication once again. At minus 2 index, this is 1. This is 0. 1 into 0 is 0, right? At minus 3 index, this is 1. This is 0. 1 to 0 is 0. Similarly, all others are zeros. Whenever these are non-zeros. Non-zero into 0. This is 0, right? Once again, 0. Then what about y of minus 3? Yeah. Is it 0 or non-zero?
That one also 0, sir.
0, right? Because you shift this by one more sample left side. It will become like minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, and so on. Once again, same thing, right? Point by point multiplication. At the same index, you will try to multiply the samples. After that, you will sum all of them. Once again, we are going to end up with 0, right? Then what about y of n for all n less than 0? Yeah, what will be this? Is it 0? This is 0. If you want, you can cross check. For minus 1, we got 0. Minus 2, we got 0. Minus 3, we got 0. And if you shift further and further left side, you will get multiplication always 0 only, right? It's unchanged. You are going to end up with y of n equal to 0. I need to find what's happening for n greater than 0 or n greater than equal to 0. Y of 0, is it 0 or non-zero? Y of 0 is nothing but sigma k equals to minus infinity plus infinity x of k h of 0 minus k, this one, right? N equal to 0. 0 minus anything but h of minus k. And this is my x of k. X of k keeps on decreasing. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. And this side, that is minus 3, and so on. 3, 1, a square, a cube, a power 4, and so on. And h of minus k is nothing but 0 minus 1 minus 2 minus 3. You see 1, otherwise that is equal to 0 for all of this. You see my h of minus k. You see my x of k. If I multiply these two things, is it 0 always?
No, sir.
At this point, this is non-zero, right? 1 into 1. 1 into 1 is 1. At this point, the two graphs are non-zeros. 1 plus, this is 0 and something is 0. And 0 and something is 0, 0 and something is 0, like that. All of those are zeros. Like that. And at this point, if I go this way, 1 into 0, this is 0, right? And okay, a into 0 is 0, a square into 0 is 0, and a cube into 0 is 0, plus and so on. I'm going to get like 1. It means I got y of 0 equal to 1, y of 0 equal to 1. Then what about y of 1? Yes, what about y of 1? If I want to go for y of 1, what I'll do is, I'll try to go with this, right? Replacing 0 with 1, n equal to 1. You see, n minus, I'll do n equal to 1. Then what will be my h of 1 minus k? Is it shifting left side or right side?
Right side.
H of 1 minus k means? Shifting h of minus k right side by one sample. Right side by one sample means 0 shifted to 1, minus 1 shifted to 0, minus 2 shifted to minus 1, minus 3 shifted to minus 2. This will be my h of 1 minus k. Now if I try to multiply point by point at the same indices, 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on, then what I'm going to get is at 0 index, 1 into 1, 1, right? And at index 1, 1 into a plus a. Index 2, 0 into something is 0. And at 3, 0 into a cube is 0. At 4, 0 into a power 4 is 0. And so on. And left side also same thing, right? 0 into 1, 0. 0 into 0, 0 into 1 is 0. 0 into 0 is 0, and so on. 0 plus, 0 plus, and so on. I'm going to get 1 plus a. Y of 1 equals to 1 plus a. Then what about y of 2? Then you guess.
One plus a plus a square.
See, shifting h of 1 minus k by one more unit right side. Otherwise, you can think like shifting h of minus k right side by 2 units. Are shifting h of 1 minus k by one more unit. Like that you can think, right? This will become like 2. This will become like 3, 4, 5. This will be 1. This will be 0. This will be minus 1. Now, at 0 index, 0 into 1, 1, right? And at index minus 1, 1 into 0 is 0. And for all others, 0, right? 0 into something. And at index 1, 1 into 1 is... Okay, at index 1, 1 into a, right? This is a. At index 2, a square. Index 3, 0 into a cube. And so on. All others are zeros. 1 plus a plus a square. Then what about y of 3? Y of 3. Replace this with 3. What about y of 3?
1 plus a square plus a cube, sir.
One more unit right side by one unit, right? Otherwise, I can say shift h of minus 2, h of minus k right side by 3 units. Or shift h of 2 minus k, one more unit right side by one unit, right? One more unit, like that again thing. And then this will be shifted to 1, this will be shifted to 0, and this will be shifted to 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on. Now, at location 0, 1 into 1, 1. And at location 1, 1 into a. At location 2, 1 into a square. The a square. At location 3, 1 into a cube. And all other 0 and something is 0. Similarly, this side, 0 and something is 0. This is what I am going to get. 1 plus a square plus a cube. And what about y power 4? Y of 4.
Y of 3 plus a power 4.
Oh, one minute, y of 4, right? Y of 4 means four minus k. Shifting h of away 4 units. Okay, let me erase this just for convenience. Four minus k means this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on. This will be 0, -1 and so on. H of 4 minus k means. Now 1 into this is a, right? This is a. 1 into a plus 1 into a square. At index 2, this is a square, right? And 1 into at index 3, a cube. Plus 1 into a power 4. After that, 0 and something is 0. 0 and something is 0. It means I am going to get a plus a square plus a cube. Yeah, can someone guess what is my y of 5?
A square plus a cube plus a power 4 plus a power
4. A square plus a cube plus a power 4 plus a power 5. Because this will extend till a power infinity. A power infinity is x of k. And my y of 6 will be a cube plus a power 4 plus a power 5 plus a power 6. This is my y of 6. And from this, what is your observation? Now, what's my plan is, see, till now I did like this, h of n equal to u of n minus u of n minus 4. Instead of this, if I consider my h of n as follows, u of n minus capital N, where n is some positive integer. Then what will be my final outcome y of n? So first we can write for this one. From this you can try to write that second one. Okay, for n less, forget about this case, consider that first case only. What do you got for n less than 0? Y of n?
Zeros.
Zero, right? We got y of n equal to 0 for n less than 0. 0 for n less than 0. And that is equals to, some form we got, right? Let me have this. Y of 0 is 1. Y of 1 is 1 plus a. Okay, let me write that also. Y of 0 equal to 1 and y of 1 equals to 1 plus a. Y of 2 equals to 1 plus a square. we have 3 equals to 1 plus a plus a square plus a cube. After that, this 1 we are missing, right? We have 4 means that 1 is missing. And we have 5 also, a also missing, right? The starting terms. The first term is missing and one extra term is getting added. Like that we are getting. Up to this, some pattern that's followed, right? Yeah, what is that? Then how to write this? One, two, three, that is following some pattern. Can you just tell me that pattern?
A power 0 to A power n.
Okay, that is something like sigma k equal to 0 to n A power n. Do you agree this? Suppose n equal to 1. N equal to, is it true or false, this one? Okay, 0 to 3, right? 0 to 3. Y of 0 means I get 1. Sigma k equal to 0 to 0. For n equal to 0, k equal to 0 to 0. I have 1 a power 0, which is nothing but 1. For n equal to 1, k equal to 0 to 1, right? A power k. A power k means 1 plus a. And for n equals to 2, k equal to 0 to 2, right? 1 plus a square. For n equal to 3, k equal to 0 to 3. It means a power 0 means 1. 1 plus a square plus a cube. This got satisfied, right? There's no issue with that. And what about this for n greater than 3? Or n greater than or equal to 4 or n greater than 3? Anything you can understand? Yeah. What about this? Okay, have a look into this pattern. Y of 4 means the final term we are going to get is 4. Y of 5 means the final term we are going to get is 5. Y of 6 means the final term we are going to get is a power 6. This is matching. 4, 3, 2, 1. 5, 4, 3, 2. We have total 4 terms, right? 4 elements. Before to this index, we have 3 more things. Before 6, we have 3 more things, right? Like that we have. It means, yeah, can someone help me how to write this? Till n, that's okay. But I should decrease n from till what point?
N minus 3.
N minus 3. Yeah, that's fine. Let me check for n equal to 4. For n equal to 4, this is going to get k equal to 4 minus 3. 1, 2, n equal to 4, right? A power k. Yeah, this is true, right? A plus a square plus a cube plus a power 4. And for n equal to 4, n equal to 5, this will be 2 to 5. It means a square plus a cube plus a power 4 plus a power 5. Yeah, it's true. I can have my y of n like this. Suppose I want to generalize this one. I want to generalize this thing. Based on this 4, I want to go with some capital N, where N is some positive integer. And how to do this? Yeah, replace this one with
capital N minus 1, sir.
Here N, right? N minus 1. Same thing. Replace this with N minus 1. Otherwise, if you have another format, you can write like N greater than or equal to N. That's also fine. It's also okay. There's no issue, right? Here, if you want, you can write like n less than 4. Less than 4. Yeah, no issues with that. Yeah, that's what we are going to get. Can someone simplify this? Sigma k equal to 0 to n, a power k. Yeah, what is the implication of this? A power 0 means 1 plus a plus a square plus and so on plus a power n. Let me consider some n which is more than this, just for understanding purpose. Geometric series, right? Yeah, why the summation? Is it n or n plus 1?
N plus 1.
You might have seen this. AR plus AR square plus and so on. AR power n equals to initial term, right? And that fraction is R. A into 1 minus R power is n. Total number of terms, 1, 2, 3, up to n plus 1, right? R power 1 to R power n. N terms are there and extra one term, right? Total number of terms divided by 1 minus R. The reverse also fine. You want to can write R power n plus 1 minus 1 by R minus 1. Because this minus gets cancelled out, right? I multiply and divide with minus 1. You can write in the reverse way. That's also okay. There's no issue with that. Is it n or n plus 1? That R is nothing but A here. That fraction. A power 1, A power 2, A power n, right? Number of terms are n plus 1. N plus 1. Like this you can write, right? And what about this one? N minus 3 to n a power k. Okay, this can be written like n minus 3 plus a power n minus 3 plus 1 plus a power n minus 3 plus 2. And so on up to plus a power n, right? Okay, a power n minus 3. Okay, and so on is not required. Because I have written all the things, right? N minus 3 plus 3. I can take a power n minus 3 common, then 1 plus a power 1 plus a square plus a cube. A 3 into. And what will be this? Once again, you can write like that, right? There are four terms. 1 minus a power 4 divided by 1 minus a. Like this, you can write, right? In this example, we consider capital N equal to 4. Now we can replace 4 with n. This will be n and this will be n minus 1. 3 will be n minus 1, right? This will also be n minus 1. Just for your understanding purpose. This will be n minus 1. 3 will be n minus 1. Like that you can have. Yeah, this expression we are going to get. You can have a look into this generalized version. Tabular method for linear convolution. You might have seen this in signals and systems, right? Let me rewind this once again. Okay, let me consider this. 2, 1, minus 1, 0.
Minus 3, sir.
Okay, 1 to minus 1. And let me consider this as my starting. This is zero index, x sub 0, x sub 1, x sub 2, x sub 3, like that. And this is my zero index, h of 0, h of minus 1, h of 1. Like that. I want to do convolution of the two things. Okay, that can be written as follows. This is my h of n, this side. 2, 1, minus 1, 0, 3. And this will be my h of n. 1, 2, minus 1. Now I'll try to multiply point by point. For that one. 2 into 1 is 2, right? And 1 into 1 is 1. 1 into something. This is 1, right? 0, 3. 2 into 2, 4. 2 into 1, 2. Minus 2, 0, 6. Minus 1 into this thing, right? Minus 2, minus 1, 1, 0, minus 1 to 3, minus 3. Yeah, what's my next step? I think you might have seen this earlier, right? Yeah, what's your next step then?
We have to add the diagonal, sir.
Yes, diagonal one, right? We'll try to add this one, and after that, this one. After that, this one. After that, this one, this one, this one, like that, the diagonal things. So it'll be 2, it'll be 5. Okay, we're going to end up with 2, 5, minus 2 plus 2 is 0, minus 1. This is minus 1, minus 3. Yeah, if there is any mistake, you can inform me. Minus 3. And this is 4, this is 6, this is minus 3. And where will be my zero index? You can see sum of lower limits, sum of upper limits, right? Lower limit, lower index in this case is 0. Upper index is 1, 2, 3, 4. Lower index in this one is minus 1, right? Because this is 0. Sum of lower limits, sum of upper limits. This should be minus 1, this should be 5. This should be minus 1, starting point. Then this should be 0, right? Index 0. And this will be 1, 2, 4, 5. Index 5. This is my y of 5. Y of n. Y of minus 1, y of 0, y of 1, and so on, y of 5. Okay, can you just tell me how you got this one? This is an assignment for you. What you need to do is, in place of writing 2 straight away, you can do this. X of 0. In place of having 1, you can have x of 1. In place of minus 1, write x of 2. Here, write x of 3. This is x of 4, right? Then what is this? H of 0, h of minus 1, h of 1, right? This is minus 1. And this replace with h of 0. Replace this one with h of 1. Now, do multiplication. Replace this 2 with x of 0 into h of minus 1. Replace this one with h of minus 1 into x of 1. Replace this one with h of minus 1 into x of 2. And this one is nothing but h of 0 into x of 0. This one is nothing but h of 0 into x. You can try to have these notations. And you can do similarly this addition. Then try to compare with your linear convolution sum. That expression is there, right? Try to compare with this expression, n minus k. That one. Then you are going to end up with the same thing. You can have that exact intuition behind that, right? Once you do that one. In that way, you can find the linear convolution. And this, as we discussed in the last class. Yeah, it's already late, right? Thank you. Okay, do you have any doubts?